Lastly, I just want to say to everyone else outside of the class of 2020, leave the kids alone. Please let, you know, the class of 2020 now needs our support more than ever than people bashing students, like saying, ah, like, you know that thing where like where people are busy mocking students that, oh, this one failed. Well, this one thought they were like the, oh yeah, they were busy doing this, yeah. You know, in the streets, Gandhi, yeah, they're not work. Hey, this is not the time, especially if you're an older person, stop bashing students. Because again, when it comes to, for example, failure, it's not usually like one single factor that might cause someone to actually fail. There's quite a lot of other things out there that might make someone lose concentration. And these are the factors that you know nothing about, which is why you should never judge a person just because someone failed their matric. No. This is when now you need to step up, you know, be the leader for that person, be the haven for that person, support them. Now I'm going to give you examples of how you can support some of these, you know, like students. So for an example, help them, you know, like they all have their CVs and stuff. Help them structure their CV, how to structure a CV. You know, like while, for example, they get a job somewhere, for example, help them. How do you navigate this? And then you see that, oh, there's a student, for example, who's passionate about, as you know, like, for example, I'll mention again, chef. I don't know, that's because I'm not very good when it comes to cooking, but I'm just using being a chef as an example. You know that this kid, you know that this this person is very good, you know, with food and catering. And for example, you in a company, just try, for example, your company to say, hey, I know this person who's actually good at baking and all these things. How about, for example, we let them bake for our next meeting, and then, you know, you get to support them now with, not first of all linking them with a person in the company, because this might be their future employer, and also, for example, also a future client. You are in finances or you're an accountant, why don't you help these students, for example, register their businesses or make sure, give them like point, like the basics of how to start a business. Or, for an example, you own a car, and why don't you help a student, not even many of them, just one student, teach one student how to drive, you know, make sure that they get their learners and their driver's licenses while they, for example, they're still looking for school. This will help them quite a lot. Again, you don't need to be, you know, be there for someone, or, for example, all financially. Because not all of us actually are financially sound, but you know, you can do a little bit just to help. Instead of stressing students, help them.